to families today. And welcome to those who travel from wherever it might be, all parts of London, Nigeria, of course, Vancouver. I heard any advance on Vancouver. pretty good. We've come a long way, and this is now the centre of your world for this afternoon. A great day has arrived, as you come to witness and to celebrate the marriage of Joyce and Zuby. You're not just spectators, you're not just attending a social event. You are the witnesses and the guests. You have a part to play as Joyce and Zuby affirm and seal their relationship and commit themselves to a new and exciting future together. This is a new beginning, a life-changing moment for them. They will be altered at the altar here. So I'm sure you're going to join in enthusiastically and share this moment with Joyce and Zuby as they pledge themselves to their lifetime of sharing and make their vows to each other. So remember, this is a religious ceremony. The vows made today are serious and solemn, unique and lifelong, and made here in the presence of God, this holy place, God's house, the home to of the local Christian community. I can't offer any guarantees of a happy hereafter, but there's no better way to make that great commitment to the adventure of marriage, and it's no better way to begin building the loving and lasting relationship which the words and actions and prayers of this Christian marriage service set before us. So we begin with the traditional Christian greeting, grace, mercy and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. And the most important verse in the Bible, God is love. Those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. So we pray that we may feel the presence of God with us now. The God of wonder and of joy, grace comes from you. You alone are the source of life and love. Without you we cannot please you. Without your love, our deeds are worth nothing. So send your Holy Spirit and pour into our hearts that most excellent gift of love. We may worship you now with thankful hearts, and serve you always with willing minds, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We're going to sing the first of the songs that are chosen by Jimmy and Joyce. We're going to sing How Great Is Our God.
Thank you. the Lord does the church. For we are members of his body, of his flesh, and of his blood. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and join to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. This is a great mystery, but I speak concerning Christ and the church. Nevertheless, let each one of you in particular so love his own wife as himself, and let wife see that she respects her husband. This is the word of the Lord.
And these words of introduction to the marriage service very much reflect the words of that reading and explain why marriage is so central to our lives. Because we have come together in the presence of God to witness the marriage of Joyce and Zuby and to ask God's blessing on them and to share in their joy. Our Lord Jesus Christ was himself a guest at a wedding in Cana of Galilee, and through his Spirit he is with us now. So the Bible teaches us that marriage is a gift of God in creation, a means of his grace, a holy mystery in which man and woman become one flesh. It is God's purpose that as husband and wife give themselves to each other in love throughout their lives, they shall be united in that love as Christ is united with his church. Now marriage is given that husband and wife may comfort and help each other, living faithfully together in need and in plenty, sorrow and in joy. It is given them a delight and tenderness. They may know each other in love, and through the joy of their bodily union, they strengthen the union of their hearts and their lives. It is given as the foundation of family life, in which children may be born and nurtured in accordance with God's will, to his praise and glory. And finally, in marriage, husband and wife, they belong to one another and begin a new life together in the community. It is a way of life that all should honour, and it must not be undertaken carelessly, lightly or selfishly, but reverently, responsibly, and after serious thought. So this is the way of life created and hallowed by God, that Joyce and Zuby are now to begin. So they will each give their consent to the other, they will join hands and exchange solemn vows, and in token of this, they will give and receive rings. So on this their wedding day, we pray for them, that strengthened and guided by God, they may fulfill his purpose for the whole of their earthly life together. Would you like to stand up? First, I'm required to ask anyone present who knows a reason why these persons may not lawfully marry to declare it now. So the vows that you are about to take and remain in the presence of God, who is the judge of all and knows all the secrets. So if either of you knows the reason why you have been lawful and married, you must declare it now. So Zuby, will you take Joyce to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honor her, and forgive her? And forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live. I will. And Joyce, will you take Zuby to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and protect him? And forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live. I have a question for you all, to which I hope you're going to reply. We will. So let's hear it. This is the question, though. Will you, the friends and families of Joyce and Zuby, support and uphold them in their marriage, now and in the years to come?
We will.
Thank you. That calls for a prayer. God our Father, from the beginning, you have blessed creation with abundant life. So pour out your blessings on Joyce and Zuby, as that they may be joined in mutual love and companionship, in holiness and in commitment to each other. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. I invite you to stand to witness the marriage. So Victor has brought Joyce to be married to Zuby, and in the presence of God, and of you all, they now join hands and make their vows to each other. I, Zuby, take you, Joyce.
I, Zuby, take you, Joyce.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
Better for us.
Better for us.
The richer for poorer.
The richer
for poorer.
The sickness and the
sickness. to love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till the death of us do part.
Till the death of us do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
I make this vow.
I make this vow.
I shall take easy leave.
I shall take easy leave.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
And to hold.
And to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
The better for us.
The better for us.
The richer for all.
The richer for all.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
I make this vow. Bless the rings. Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let these rings be to Joyce and to me, symbols of unending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vow and covenant which they make this day. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Greetings to all. This lesson is taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 13, reading from verse 8 to the end. Love never fails. For where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be still. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. For when completeness comes, what is in part disappears. When I was a child, I taught like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. And when I became a man, I put the ways of childhood behind me. But now we see earlier reflection as in the mirror. Then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. And now these three remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let me be one of the first to congratulate the latest husband and wife in the universe. Congratulations. I'm only going to speak very briefly, so no anxiety. Just a few moments from God's word. I'm going to read from the book of John chapter 2. The wedding at Cana. You probably heard this story quite a few times. Let me very quickly read it to you from verse 1. And on the third day there was a marriage in Cana of Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. And both Jesus was called and his disciples to the marriage. And when they wanted wine, the mother of Jesus saith unto him, they have no wine. And Jesus saith unto her, woman, what have I to do with thee? Mine hour is not yet come. But his mother saith unto the servants, whatsoever he saith unto you, do it. And there were set there 6 water pots of stone, after the manner of the purifying of the Jews, containing 2 or 3 firkins apiece. Jesus saith unto them, fill the water pots with water, and they filled them up to the brim. And he saith unto them, draw out now, and bear unto the governor of the feast. And they bear it. And when the ruler of the feast had tasted the water that was made wine, and knew not whence it was, but the servants which drew the water knew, the governor of the feast called the bridegroom, and saith unto him, every man at the beginning doth set forth good wine, and when men have well drunk, then that which is worse, but thou hast kept the good wine until now. This beginning of miracles did Jesus in Cana of Galilee, and manifested forth his glory, and his disciples believed in him. You've kept the best wine till last. Let's talk about the best wine. Can I announce to somebody that your best days are not behind you, they're before you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, in these few moments, I ask that you speak through me, and you cause these words to be a blessing to the couple, and to those of us that are here gathered. and that we will draw inspiration, instruction, and whatever else we need from these few words in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Like I said, just a few moments I will share from this scripture that we've probably all heard from copiously at other times. It's significant that this scripture says this is the beginning of Jesus' miracles. And Jesus chooses to begin his miracles at a wedding ceremony. That's extremely significant. It was evidence of Jesus endorsing marriage. He was willing to be at a wedding ceremony, not just because he was invited, but also for a message to us about how important marriage is. He was willing to start his ministry from a marriage ceremony, from a wedding ceremony. Backstepping just a little bit, it's also very important to note that he was invited. And I think that's the first word of instruction that I would draw to you and to all of us here. That whatever we are doing, whatever you do, make sure Jesus is invited.
Amen.
Make sure Jesus is invited. This was probably the best decision that this couple made, to make sure that Jesus was invited to their wedding. We know the rest of the story. If Jesus was not there, God knows what would have happened in that particular wedding ceremony. It's important that you make sure that Jesus is invited into your home. This is significant because the absence of Jesus means that when there is a challenge, you have very little to turn to, if anything at all. But before I even say anything more about that, let me underscore this, that the presence of Jesus does not preclude challenges and problems. Jesus was in the wedding ceremony, but they still ran out of wine. Jesus was in the ship with his disciples, crossing to the other side, and a storm still arose. Anybody that preaches a gospel that gives us the impression that once you accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, there will be no longer any problems in your life, just told you a fat lie. That Jesus is in your life doesn't mean you won't have challenges. That Jesus is in your business doesn't mean that you won't go through storms. That Jesus is in your marriage doesn't mean that you won't have disagreements. It's very important for us to understand that. That the presence of Jesus is not always the absence of trouble, but is the assurance that when trouble comes, he that can speak to the winds and the waves is there to speak. But before Jesus can speak into your situations or your circumstances, it's important that you don't just invite him to be the unseen guest in your business, in your relationship, in your marriage, in your career. I don't know how many of us have seen this popular plaque that we typically place in our houses. Jesus is the unseen guest in this house, the silent listener to every conversation, and you know the rest of it? Well, I give you the permission today to go and take it down. Because Jesus does not want to be the unseen guest or the silent listener. Jesus wants to be able to speak. Jesus wants to be able to give direction. Jesus wants to be able to give instruction. The Word of God says that where the Spirit of the Lord is given lordship, there will be liberty. If he is not given lordship, there won't be liberty. I want to challenge you to make sure that you allow Jesus to be the Lord of your marriage. Let him be the director. Let him be the instructor. Don't just have him be the silent guest there. Interesting enough, in this story, Jesus apparently wanted to be the unspoken silent guest, but for the insistence of his mother Mary. And even when he still told her, I'm not going to do anything, she turned to the servant and said, whatever he says to do, do it. Whatever the word of God tells you to do, do it. In your marriage, when you face various challenges, you've been married for a while now, have some kids, you have yours. There will be various challenges at various junctions. Whatever Jesus says to do, do it. And Jesus gave instructions here. He said, go and fill the jars full of water. And they filled it to the brim. And then he said, draw out of that and they drew out of the full jars. They took it to the governor of the feast, and they found out that this water had become wine. New wine is going to be your portion, Jesus.
Amen.
But before we celebrate that, note the instructions. It said that the jar must be full. The word of God lets us know in the book of Ephesians that the word of God is as water. So when Jesus gave the instruction that those jars should be full of water, he was also symbolically, prophetically, telling us that we need our jars to be full of the water of God's word. Let the word of God fill your jar. Now note, he didn't say draw out of the jar when the water is half full or three quarters full. He said only when it is full to the brim. The problem with a lot of us sometimes is that we draw from half full jars and wonder why the water has not turned into wine. The jar has to be full. You have to be full of God's word before when you draw out of it, it becomes wine. Let the word of God dwell richly in you. Let the word of God be the guide in your marriage. The master of the feast said, most people serve the best wine first. You've kept it till last. People serve the best wine first because they know that if they serve the best wine first, people's senses would have become a bit dull later in the ceremony. By the time you start serving the bad wine, they can't tell the difference. But he says, you've kept the best till last. This is prophetic. God is trying to let you know that your best is not behind you. Your best is before you. Your path will shine brighter and brighter until the perfect day. You're going to move from level to level, from glory to glory. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I want you to take these few words to heart. And I want even the listeners today to take these few words to heart and apply to your unique situations. Yours might not be a wedding or marriage. It might be your business. It might be some other type of relationship in your life. It might be your career. Make sure that Jesus is invited. Let him give the instructions. Fill yourself up to the brim till it overflows with God's word, and then it will become new wine. Let me take a moment and prophesy new wine into our lives,
amen,
into our situations,
amen,
even into the various marriages that are represented here. May new wine, a freshness, come into your union.
Amen.
You know, some people, when you've been married for a while, you can take each other for granted. But the mercies of God are new every morning.
Amen.
Great is his faithfulness. May that be your experience.
Amen.
Let's share a short word of prayer. Mighty Father, I thank you for your word. I thank you for your instructions. I thank you for your revelation. I pray that the seed of the word sown in our lives will bring forth much fruit. I pray for every single person here that in the name of Jesus, you will reveal yourself afresh unto each person here, that they will see you in a new light and allow you to navigate them through the challenges and storms of life onto the other side,
amen,
in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I pray for marriages here that they will be renewed and refreshed,
amen,
and they will experience new wine. Wherever they've run out of wine, run out of drive, run out of passion, run out of love, run out of unity, Lord, I ask that there will be a refilling,
amen,
with new wine in the name of Jesus. I pray for those that are not yet married, that you will order their steps into the right relationship and ultimately the right marriage in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, cause each one of us to have a testimony of your goodness. Even as we've come to witness this wonderful joining, that we too will testify of the great things you are doing in our lives.
Amen.
I'm going to ask you to join me in a moment and stretch your hands towards the couple as we pray for the couple. In just a few moments, I want you to ask that God will bless them indeed. That God will take them from level to level. That God will cause the heavens to be opened over them. He will cause the earth to yield its increase unto them. That he will cause their union to be forever indeed. He will be strong. It will grow stronger with each day. It will be the threefold cord that is not easily broken. We pray that they will follow the Lord intently and closely all the days of their lives. Pray for their union that it will be blessed with fruitfulness. Raise up a hedge of protection around them and decree and declare that none of the plans of the enemy as regards them will prosper. In the name of Jesus, you've come to witness this union, this joining now from the sincerity of your heart. Pray that they will be blessed indeed. The blessing of the Lord it maketh rich, and it addeth no sorrow. Let that be their testimony, that sorrow be far from them, that they will increase in wealth, not just material or financial wealth, but also the intangible wealth that are even more valuable. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for Zuby and Joyce, Lord, and we thank you for bringing them together and joining them today. We pray that the blessings of heaven, irresistible, will be upon them.
Amen.
Lord, in the name of Jesus, that the earth will respond to them and yield its increase unto them. We prophesy fruitfulness unto them in all their ways. In the name of Jesus, their steps are ordered away from evil and only into that which is good in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Grant them agreement, grant them knowledge, understanding, and wisdom, and unity in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Cause them to fulfill purpose, cause their union to provoke many others unto good works in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
No weapon fashioned or formed against them shall prosper. And every tongue that rises up against them in judgment, we condemn.
Amen.
Even right now, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, we thank you. We give you the glory. Let the blessings of Abraham, the blessing in the lineage of Christ, be manifest, evident, and abound in their lives in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
We trust you, Lord, to do far more than we've asked, far more than we've prayed, because we've prayed in the name that guarantees an answer. The mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And the people said aloud, amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So wherever we are on life's journey, we pray that the best, and remember that the best is yet to come, that Jesus will go with us, and that we make that prayer especially for Zuby and Joyce today. And in my book, the prayer ends, that they may come at last to the end of their lives with hearts content and in joyful anticipation of heaven. The best is indeed yet to come. And because this is an Anglican church, I'm going to ask you to join in the Lord's Prayer in the traditional Anglican way. So we say, Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen.
So let's stand to sing again. Bless the Lord, O my soul. So we ask God's blessing upon you all. May God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love, defend you on every side, and guide you in truth and peace. So may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you today and always. Amen. They can sign the registers and give them their marriage certificate. If you'd like to sit and wait quietly before they emerge. And you will find a connection plate on the way out. We do have to be self-supporting these days. And a way of saying thank you, perhaps, but thank you to all for coming and making this such a wonderfully happy occasion.
You're welcome. the bride, dancing with the spirit of the groom, and get excited.
Let's welcome them specially. It's a special day. Brilliant, thank you very, very much. A round of applause for all of them, please.